Alright guys, oh, where am I? Let's get all my crap up here. I'm going to try something really different. I'm going to try and make a bow. This is a piece of wood I got from the woods about at least a year ago. Yeah, probably about a year ago. And it is a type of wood. I have no idea what type of wood it is. And as a result, this bow is probably going to not work. It's probably going to break, or it's probably not going to pull to full draw, or something along those lines. But I figured I've got nothing better to do because my parents are away, and I've got my pupsy here to help. Are you going to come into the camera? Just going to lie in the sun. Anyway, don't expect great things from this video because, like I said, it's probably not going to work. The camera's probably going to run out of battery. I'm going to keep stopping it so that it doesn't run out of battery, hopefully. Also, because my camera doesn't have a flip screen, I don't know if I'm actually in the camera shot most of the time. I'll do a focus test in a second. But I want to talk about a few things that I have here so that you can do this yourself, hopefully. So, as I said, I don't know what kind of wood this is. There are woods that are good for bow making and there are woods that are bad. You don't want to use a soft wood like spruce or fir trees or something like that. This is relatively hard. Not amazingly hard. And what you want is straight grain, and what that means is you've got all the rings inside the tree. It just means that it should be straight. I don't really know how to describe it. There's lots of fibres inside the tree trunk that go from end to end, and if they go round knots and stuff like that, it's bad. This has no knots on it. I don't think. No, this has no knots, so this is good. This is good for a beginner. Oh, actually, I have one tiny one here, but that's nothing to worry about. And what I did is I took the bark off, and then I skimmed off the layer just underneath the bark that was all kind of soft and spongy. So this is hopefully one growth ring. And because the rings on this piece of wood are not visible at all, like you really can't see them. Yeah, you can barely see them. That was kind of hard, but because I just did it underneath the bark, it should be good. So I'm not going to touch the back of the bow at all. As you can see, it's not particularly tall. It's a pretty short bow, but that should be about the right distance to actually make a powerful bow, as long as it bends properly. But we shall see. We shall see. What I've got for tools, I've got a knife. Probably not going to be using the knife much, that's just quite useful. I have a wood rasp, this is going to be very important later on when I'm fine-tuning it. I got one of these things I can't remember the name of, but that takes off just a little bit of wood at a time. And then I've got a draw knife, which takes off quite a lot of wood at a time. And I don't think this is very sharp. No, it doesn't. Oh, that's not too bad. Not too bad. I've also got this thing, which here rocks. And I have a vise, which I can attach to it later if I need to. But I don't think I'll need to use this too much. Anyway, let's make sure I'm in focus. That looks about right. And I'm just going to start doing stuff. Are you helping? Are you helping, are you? She likes the sun. Yes, anyway. Okay, let's take a look at what I've done. So what I've done taken this big thick bit here and taken it down a bit. Now, because this is a really small kind of bit of wood that I started with, I mean, that is the full size of it, I'm gonna have quite a lot of wood left on the other side of the bow. Right here, you can see this is the centerpiece. This goes right down the middle of the bow. It's this kind of hole at the end. So I'm going to cross that when I, you know, as I go thinner and thinner. And I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It's definitely not what a proper self-bow would look like, because on a proper self-bow, you would never go on the other side of this centre, but we'll see what we can do. I mean, if you want to make a proper bow, don't watch this video. I guess it's too late now, you're invested. Also, the bow has quite a large twist on it. Now, this, as I said, this has been sitting in my bedroom for about a year, so it's twisted, but that also means it's dried, which is good. You can see a huge twist there. And I'm going to try and compensate for that twist by taking more wood off the twisted bit. Again, not good bow practice, but might work. Being wood, it's bad for you. So what I've got now is a bit of wood that goes thinner and thinner and thinner. And this bit doesn't really go very thin until about here, so I need to take more off that bit. And actually, looking at this again, this handle is very big. And it's much bigger than my hand. In fact, I could take half of it off. So I will do, to make this bow have longer working limbs. So I'm gonna take this initial cut in a few inches on each side. Stop eating grass! So you call it. You're grazing. You look like a cow and now you're acting like a cow. Wish me luck. Nah, not a hope. Nowhere near enough wood's been taken off to bend it yet. I'm gonna go inside and get a drink. Dog's gone in. She decided that sitting in the sun outside the house was just far too stressful. So sitting in the sun on the inside of the house made much more sense. That's better. Now you can see my sexy thighs. Right, more wood off here. I'm gonna leave the tips for now, but more wood off here. I have to take so much more wood off this thing. Okay, so as you can see, the more wood I take off, the more this central soft spot is being revealed. So I've got it coming down all the way to here. Now, I don't want to go any further into the wood yet. until I have it bending evenly on both sides. We still have a fairly bad twist, but on the whole, it's still pretty straight. So I'm cautiously optimistic. Now, I was thinking a little bit about how I want this bow to, how I want it to turn out, and this is assuming that it works. Oh, and that I don't break the bow. What I want to do is, you see this, the end is kind of big. It doesn't get thinner and thinner and thinner until the tip. So I think what I want to do is narrow these bits out to make kind of levers or sias or sias. I think sias sounds more. I think it's it. Anyway. To make levers here, non-bending stiff bits at the tips. I have two reasons for this. One, because tips are weak. This isn't a good wood, this isn't a good bow wood. I don't want my tips to snap. So I think that could help. Two, because this bow is twisted, I want to compensate for the twist as much as I can. Having two grooves for the string to go in is going to, basically the string's going to be pulling more on one of those grooves, likely to slip out. So what I want is for a single groove going in from the back. Yeah. So that's what I'm going to do now. So effectively what I'm going to be doing is making it thinner and thinner and thinner, but I'm not going to be making it thinner and thinner that way. Just that way. Let's try it. I've thinned up my tips a bit. They're not even, but not to worry yet. I'm going to take a little bit more wood off of the whole length of each of these limbs up to about here and here. Just thin up this whole section here. Also, I've noticed I've done something really stupid. I thought that this was my center. This is my center, that was the grip. So what I've done is on one side I've gone up to my center and on the one side I've gone to the grip. So this limb is considerably longer than this one. So what I'm going to do is bring this one into the middle. Which it won't be too much of a problem because this isn't going to bend here at this thickness. There's no way. So I'll do that. Okay. So from bending it on the floor, I've noticed that it bends too much here. This bit, not enough here. So if I take wood off here, then those two should bend evenly. Also, I'm not getting enough bend here, so I need to take more wood off here. I'm going to leave this bit because that's kind of fine tuning. But this bit I can do with the draw knife. All right, battery's running low, so. Ow. I'm gonna stop now and I'm gonna come back to this later when it's virtually charged, or tomorrow, depending on stuff. So yeah, there it is.